Good morning, Holy Spirit. For the strength and power of prayer this day. Oh Lord God, breathe afresh on us so that we will pray without ceasing. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, how often do we tell others we will pray for them, but our mind becomes preoccupied with other thoughts and we forget to pray for their need? Or how often do we rush to find a solution to a problem instead of bringing the problem to our Heavenly Father and asking Him for help? Our lives and the lives of those around us are filled with relationships, circumstances, and decisions that are in need of prayer each day. So why don't we more instinctively think of approaching God's throne to secure the assistance of heaven before we search for solutions on our own? How often is prayer our last resort? When we encounter a difficulty, or when we hear of global distresses or family issues, we are apt to run to tell someone. Perhaps we check our phones for the latest news, or texts or emails. We are eager to see what our favorite pundits have to say, or our friends or family. No, we should pray. Most Christians are underutilizing the power of prayer in their lives. Prayer should be our first reaction, not our last resort. Most Christians are always looking for somebody to pray for them. But prayer is our instant connection with the power of heaven. It's our open line to the throne, and we are told to come boldly to find grace to help in time of need. Elizabeth Elliot once said, prayer lays hold of God's plan and becomes the link between His will and its accomplishment on earth. Amazing things happen, and we are given the privilege of being the channels of the Holy Spirit's prayer. Beloved, if you need to sharpen your prayer instinct, then be reminded that the Bible is a book of prayer. The more you are in God's Word, the more you'll be before His throne. The more you let Him speak to you, the more you speak to Him. Often our neglect of Scripture and our oversight of prayer are two sides of the same tarnished coin. Beloved, as you and I read and study our Bibles, we often find our best prayers are the ones we discover in the Bible itself. My dear brother and my dear sister, it is very, very important for you and I to understand that even if you don't know how to pray, your solution is learning to pray through the passages of Scripture. by so doing, you and I are studying to know how to pray, particularly loving to pray from the book of Psalms. Friends, Jesus was a man of prayer. As we work our way through the Bible, we come face to face with Jesus. In the Gospels, we see him praying, teaching others to pray, and modeling prayer in all kinds of circumstances. The renowned S.D. Gordon, in his classic book, Quiet Talks on Prayer, said, Jesus prayed. He loved to pray. Sometimes praying was his way of resting. He prayed so much and so often that it became part of his life. It became to him like breathing. Friends, the goal of the Christian life is simply to become more like Christ. He was always taking the moment to pray. Sometimes his prayer was as short as a sigh and one word, Mark 7:34. Other times it was deep, long, and far-reaching. John 17, he prayed in private, Mark 1:35, and in public, Matthew 15:35-36, he prayed for others, Luke 22:32, and for himself, Matthew 26:39. His disciples had never seen anything like it, and in awe they asked him, Lord, teach us to pray, Luke 11:1. You and I should be people of prayer. My dear brother, my dear sister, when we offer that same prayer, it helps us become people of prayer too. That's why it is very, very important for you and I to understand that God has ordained you to be a person of prayer. It is my prayer that this day, as we meditate on Luke Chapter 11, verse 1. We'll pray like the disciples of old and continue to ask the Holy Spirit to teach us to pray each and every morning. We wake up from our bed. May God richly bless you till we meet again. Bye for now. Yeah.